everyone, welcome.
Hi everyone. We all know cloud solutions like Microsoft OneDrive and Google Drive, for example.
And we also did a video on Nextcloud.
Indeed. Today we're going to talk about Synology Drive.
Yeah, it's a cloud solution from Synology, which you can run on your own NAS, so in-house. And it was released in January this year, so we gave it some time. And yeah, now it's time to test it and see if it's actually that good, if it's any good. So we're going to find out in this video. So let's have a look on the server side of things. So if we go to the package center and you type in drive, hit enter. You can see I have already installed drive. You can just hit install. It will just install two components. One is drive, of course, and the second one is drive admin console, which you can manage your drive solution. So let's do that. We are going to have a look at the drive admin console at first, and it will give you the overview of your Synology drive. So here you can see the connection info. At this moment, there are two clients connected. That will be Boobytrap and that will be Chevy. With two accounts. Yes, the location is the location of your NAS. It's on volume one. The database size is 410 megabytes at the moment. And here you can see the version Explorer. We'll get to that in a bit. Then we have the client list. As I mentioned, you can see which clients are connected with their connection info, which is online, which one is offline. And you have the log. Here you can see all the changes were made in Drive. Then we have team folder. As you can see, you have my drive, firm data, and video, which are all shared folders. And if we have a look on the control panel and shared folder, you can see I've created a new folder called firm data. And I have enabled this in the drive admin console as a firm folder. So I have given Chevy access to this folder and maybe other employees as well. It's the firm data folder and it is the root folder for the team. It's a team folder. If you click on firm data and we click on versioning, you can see enable version control and maximum version is 32. So we have 32 steps back. Once Chevy made a mistake and accidentally deleted the file, we can restore it from there. And you can access the version history from the version explorer on the overview window. So if you click that one, you have a timeline on which you can scrub and see what changes were made on your drive solution. And you can restore a file. Let's say you have deleted the old test file. You can say restore and it will put that version back. So that's a really neat function. Then we have the video folder and this one is related to Video Station because the fun thing with this is you can actually install Synology Office or Synology Video Station and you can integrate that with Synology Drive. So I have installed Synology Video Station and I have installed Synology Office. So with that, we can add and edit our Office documents to the selected share and it will add another feature set to your Synology Drive solution. Then we go to settings and with settings, you can basically edit or add, create user sync profiles on which you can sync folders and files with or exclude them from syncing. So that's basically the Drive admin console in a nutshell. Let's close this and let's have a look on Drive. And I will open this in the web browser. We're first going to have a look on the website of things. It will put me in my user folder. And you can see I have three files in here, one photo and two Excel documents. But we also have the team folder. If we're going to have a look on the team folder, we can see the folder firm data. If we open that, you can see different files because we have tested different things with this. We also have an XLS document, an Excel sheet. We have a malfunctioning PSU fan with a label on it. And we'll get back to that as well. And we can just double click an audio file, for example. Yeah, which sounds like a cricket. This is a CPU of a PSU fan of a customer of ours. And it is clearly malfunctioning. So we gave that a label contact customer. And below that we have the Synology Drive video old.txt. And below that we have the Synology Drive video, which is a normal Word document. Then we have a file with a lock icon behind it. If we double click on this file, it will ask me for a password. So we fill in the password, we press enter, and we can see the contents of this document. So this is a very important document, therefore it is encrypted. People with the password can open it. People without the password can do anything with it. So you can encrypt files with that. And we also have a video. So let's open that video. It will open with the Synology video player and it will just play it in your web browser. And you can see we also have spiders in the Netherlands. It's a very big one, to be honest. Okay, so that's the spider. And basically, those are some different file types. You can just edit in a web solution. Then we have the video folder. Here you can upload video files, and those will be synchronized with Video Station as well. So here I have a 4K video from Fallout, some gameplay. The videos I add here, as I said, will be synchronized with Video Station. So if you have the Video Station app, you can see the videos in here as well. Then we have shared with me. If Chefy wants to share a file with me, maybe it's important, you just want to share a file, he can tag that file to share with me, and I will get a notification with this bell up in the left corner, and I will get a notification here that Chefy wants to share a file with me. Shared with others, you can see I've tried this, and this one is shared with public. All the people I send this URL to, this link, can have access to this file if the Synology site is accessible from the outside. Then we have recent files. Well, here you can see all the files that have been opened, have been edited. These will be displayed here. We have start files. Of course, files marked with a star will be displayed here. We have the recycle bin. Files that are deleted will be shown here. And the labels we've created earlier. Well, let's create a label in firm data. We have the very important groceries as the ongoing label. Well, let's give the Synology Drive video a label. We can just hit the label icon and we can create a new label. So let's call this one YouTube video. Yeah, we give it a nice color and we just hit OK. So now we have added a label to this file, and you can see with the section labels comes another label, which is called YouTube video. So all the files are marked with YouTube label will be displayed here as well. Okay, so that's it for the web session. Let's have a look on the Synology Drive desktop app. I've installed this, and once you are logged in, this is the screen you are prompted with. You have a sync task. Here you can create another profile. You can add another Synology station where Drive is installed. So you can have multiple sites on the same app. So that's nice. Then we have the sync log. Here you can see the activity on your Drive, notifications, as I mentioned before. Then we have the global settings, and you can edit your preferences to your personal likings. So that's that. So let's have a look on the folder in Windows Explorer then. As you can see, this is my personal Synology Drive folder. And there's one thing that doesn't show up here. We have shared with me. Nice. We have Synology Drive. Nice as well. But there's one thing I miss here, and that's the team folder. That's basically the most important thing in this case, because how I'm going to access my files now? Now I only have access to my own personal drive. So I've set up the Synology Drive on different clients, and with the out-of-the-box setup, it doesn't show the team folder. So that's a thing. It does show up on the mobile client, and we'll switch to the mobile client right now. So Chefy, the mobile version.
Yeah, so here we have the mobile version. As we can see here, this is the standard screen in which it opens, which is my drive. As you can see, I don't have any items in this at the moment. But if we go to the top left corner, we have a selection with all the options that you have on mobile. Of course, we have the team folder, which you also have access to in the online client. So here are all the files that we had stored on there. Other than that, we have shared items. Again, nothing is shared with me.
We don't share.
No, but if you go up here, we've got the shared with others as well. Also, there's nothing in there as well, because there's nothing shared at the moment. Then we have recent files. As you can see here, all the recent files that I have used on the device. Again, start files, nothing in here because it's my own personal folder. Then we have an option for offline access.
Okay.
So I've got an option here, a file in here that I can access offline wherever I am.
Yeah.
And for example, if I'm not connected to the internet, it does store a local version on your mobile to do that. So if you edit it, the edits are not stored into the file in the team folder.
No.
So that's something to keep in mind if you want to edit a file that has offline access. Next, we have the recycle bin. So this will load files that I have deleted on my device.
Yeah.
And we have background tasks. As you can see, there's a file here that I've uploaded from my device to Synology Drive.
Yeah.
And here you can see a list of items that you have uploaded and that are either in progress or completed.
Yeah.
Again, labels like we had on the other online environment.
The web session. Yeah, indeed.
So here you can create labels as well. And other than that, there's notifications. Here you can see I've tried to upload an ISO file to the server.
Yeah.
It was a file of 3 gigabytes, but it failed to upload. It gave me a message that the host file wasn't accessible, which it clearly was. And that's about it for the functions of the mobile version.
Yeah.
One thing to note with the mobile version is that when we open a file, for example, we take the groceries, enter the password, and we only get a version that we can view.
Read only, yeah.
Read only. So there's no option in here at all to change anything to edit.
It was the same with the web session I just showed you.
Yeah.
But it's not only with this text file. It's with doc files as well. So files I can edit in the web session, you cannot edit on mobile version.
No.
Well, it's 2018. Most people have a mobile device on them all of the time, pretty much.
Exactly.
And if you can't edit your files, well, we'll get to that in the pros and cons at the end of this video. But it's a thing Chevy wants to point out now.
Yeah. Because this was something that we could do with, for example, the Office version of Nextcloud.
True.
That worked on mobile for editing as well.
Let's start with the pros. It's easy to set up. That's a first thing, really. If you have a NAS and you want to be able to manage your files yourself and not trust them to a Google or a Microsoft, just want to manage it yourself, it's easy to set up.
Yeah.
Do a little bit of configuration. Make sure your NAS is accessible from the outside. If you're not using a VPN, I strongly suggest at least use an SSL certificate. So go HTTPS on that and not HTTP.
Another pro is that it's compatible with almost every platform that is usable these days.
Yeah.
Like Android, Windows, macOS.
iOS.
iOS as well.
Yeah.
All those.
Linux. All platforms.
All platforms that anyone would use these days.
Yeah.
So that's...
With the web client as well. So basically every platform.
Exactly.
Another pro is a drive management console. I showed you in the video. It's very easy to maintain and manage the drive yourself. So that's definitely a pro.
Mm-hmm. Indeed. The last pro we're going to talk about is the version history.
Yeah.
So you can set this to a certain amount of versions.
Yeah, standards on 32.
32 indeed.
Yeah.
So you can go back 32 versions of a file. So for example, if you make a wrong edit, the file isn't immediately lost if you don't have a backup, because you can go back two or three versions.
Yeah.
Absolutely. It's a great
future. Yeah. Great future. Then we have the cons, and we have some of that as well. Yeah.
Yeah. One of them we've already talked about a bit before is the ability to edit files on your mobile device.
Yeah.
That's something you can't do, not only on telephones, but for example, iPads as well.
Yeah.
A lot of people use iPad Pros, for example, to editing and stuff. And you can't do that.
No, because they both use iOS, iPhone and iPad. But no, it's just a drawback. It's 2018. Basically, every other platform can do it, but they can't. And we're almost a year now ahead. January this year, it came out as a stable version. So they, by now, they could have implemented it.
Yeah, indeed. I hope they include it as well.
Yeah. Because
that would be a great upgrade to the drive version.
Yeah, definitely. Another con is the team folder. We just talked about it. Out of the box, it doesn't show up in Explorer. Like your own personal folder is there, but the team folder is not. Tried it on different clients, and on none of them, it showed up as team folder. Maybe it could be a permission issue, but I don't think so, because it does show up on mobile.
Indeed.
The point, out of the box, it doesn't work, is a thing.
Yeah. That's a thing.
So that's a con.
Another thing with viewing videos on iOS is that you can't view them unless you have a valid SSL certificate.
Yeah, so if you connect through HTTPS, so you want a secure connection with your server, and you don't have an SSL certificate installed, a valid SSL certificate, iOS doesn't allow you to view the video.
No.
No.
You would just get an error with, you can't view this without a certificate SSL.
If you have HTTP enabled, you can view them through HTTP, but as we mentioned before, we strongly suggest not to.
No.
No. Yeah, that's a con. Yeah, the last con I have is the setup of the app itself. It's not a big thing, but it's a small thing. On mobile, you set it up through your DSM port, and on the desktop client, you set it up through the drive port, which is a different port than your DSM port, so it can be a little bit confusing. So, those are the pros and cons we have so far.
Yeah.
I hope they improve several things, because it does have some potential. Okay, so with this we conclude the video. We just wanted to give you guys an overview of Synology Drive. If you have any comments, suggestions, maybe some advice regarding to this video, you can leave them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.
Bye.